What are stem cells? This presentation was delivered at Balaji Medical College a couple of years back. My interests are joint replacement, arthroscopic surgery, and ortho-biologic procedures. I call these joint biologics injections. This consists of PRP, growth factors, cells like derived from fat, bone marrow, umbilical cord. My practice is known as the Madras Joint Replacement Center. You can get in touch with me at this email address. If you are new here, kindly consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, Madras Joint Replacement Center. These are my social media links. The YouTube channel is given above, Madras Joint Replacement Center. The picture of a stem cell. What are stem cells? Cells which are capable of regenerating and replicating and repairing tissues, these specialized cells are known as stem cells. They are present in every organ and tissue in the human body, like skin, fat, bone marrow, muscle, heart, everywhere, but they are dormant. They can be kicked into action by external methods, either by a response to a trauma or by seeding the damaged area with stem cells by injection or open procedure. This is the classification of stem cells. At the top, you have the totipotent embryonic stem cell, which is formed by the fusion of the sperm to the ova. This results in a zygote and formation of a blastocyst, which further differentiates into two cell, four cell, then the embryo and the fetus and so on. The totipotent embryonic stem cell give rise to pluripotent embryonic stem cells, which form the various tissues in the three body layers, that is from inside the coelomic cavity, that is the gut, then the neural tissue, and outside you have the skin, etc. These pluripotent stem cells then give rise to multipotent stem cells, which are located in each of the tissues, as I said, present in the lung, pancreas, heart muscle, red blood cells, skin, muscle, bone marrow, and every other place. How do we isolate these stem cells for the purpose of treatment? We can aspirate them from the tissue like bone marrow or skin or fat in the outpatient or operating room. And then we manipulate it internally. By this we mean centrifugation in the office centrifuge. And after manipulation, they can be injected into the site without any further delay. This is usually done as an outpatient procedure and the patient can return home immediately or within a few hours. If an anesthesia is required, like spinal anesthesia, the patient may have to stay for a few hours in the outpatient observation room. Or the cells can be isolated like before and sent off to a tissue bank where they are cultured and stored in liquid nitrogen. Here, the number of cells is expanded to several millions and they can be kept in cold storage for as much as possible. Certain tissues have got a half-life, but some tissues can be stored for a long time. Their potency decreases after 1 year. So when these cells are expanded, they can be returned to the user or to the doctor and can be re-injected into the patient's knee or wherever after an interval of time. The advantage is that one is injecting more number of cells than is possible from a straightforward injection after a harvest. How do I apply or treat damaged areas of cartilage and bone. One can apply it to the cartilage lesion by arthroscopic or open surgery, where the joint is inspected, the area of damage is prepared by shaving and microfracture or creating holes to generate a basal foundation. Then the tissue is the cells which have been obtained, they are made into a paste, fibrin glue, and that mixture is applied to the cartilage lesion and it is shaped with a spatula. The joint is put through a range of movement and the fibrin glue sets after 5 minutes, and then the patient is returned to the OR. He will remain non-weight bearing and can resume activities, full weight bearing activities, after 6 weeks. This procedure is usually done for single or one or two cartilage lesions, but it is not applicable to multiple cartilage lesions like below, like osteoarthritis, wherein I use fluoroscopy or X-ray or C-arm or ultrasound guidance. For knee joints and shoulder joints, I use ultrasound guidance, and one can also use fluoroscopy for the same, and you can also use fluoroscopy for the shoulder, ultrasound guidance for the shoulder. They can be given as intravenous injection for distant tissues like skeletal muscle, heart, or these cells can be seeded onto a scaffold and applied to the lesion by tissue engineering. See this slide. This is the picture of a slide with seeded with chondrocytes. What are the mechanism of action of stem cells? They have a trophic effect, which means they stimulate growth via the secretion of cytokines and growth factors. That is, when these cells are injected into a joint, these growth factors are released, and they have the potency or capability of stimulating adjacent cells in the joint, like synoviocytes, to differentiate and form cartilage. These differentiating cells, when stimulated by growth factors, will go ahead and repair areas of damaged cartilage, and a limited cartilage repair is possible. Not a complete repair in the case of bone on bone. These cells have got an immune modulatory effect, which means that when these are injected, even when they are obtained from an allogenic source like umbilical cord cells, then these cells have got an immunomodulatory effect. That is, they erect a barrier between themselves and the native person's immune system, and they can go ahead and perform their function without any interference from the destructive and deleterious effects of the immune system, like the T cells and all that. So they can continue to perform their function without being affected by the body's immune system. They have an anti-inflammatory effect. That is, when injected into swollen joints, which are under the attack of inflammation, which is produced by degraded, degenerating cartilage products, then those harmful chemicals are neutralized by stem cells, and this will put a stop to the ongoing swelling, and which will result in pain relief. This will take some time, usually is apparent within a day or two, and will be in full effect, full force, within about 3 weeks. After that, there will be continuous improvement. Antibiotic effect. There is no need for a person to worry when stem cells are injected. They are not at risk of developing joint infection like septic arthritis of the knee. This is because of the antibiotic effect present in the stem cells themselves. Self-replication. They can replicate as themselves, or replication differentiate into further cell types. They have an anti-aging effect because they repair tissue. They can set back the effect of aging. What are the role of MSCs in orthopedic surgery? Main common areas are trauma and bone defects, which may result in non-unions, small non-unions, where this can be stem cells can be injected. The stem cells can be derived from bone marrow, and when injected, it can promote union. Articular cartilage repair, commonly in the knee joint, shoulder joint, or metatarsophalangeal joint of the first great toe, wherever, in this ankle joint. These cells are injected into areas of cartilage damage up to grade 4. They can repair cartilage. They can also repair osteochondral defects when they are prepared in a certain manner, and osteochondral plug is created, and they can repair articular cartilage. Osteoarthritis, when there is widespread cartilage wear of ICRS grade 3, grade 2, stem cells can help to halt the ongoing osteoarthritic process and lead to limited repair, thus reducing pain and the ability to postpone a knee replacement. Avascular necrosis. This is commonly seen in the hip joint, and it is bilateral. It can result from unnecessary steroid intake when given for pulmonary conditions, eye, skin, etc., or from alcohol or certain diseases like gauchers, which is a storage disease, deep sea diving. When people get into deep sea diving, this is called as a also in certain blood disorders like sickle cell anemia, which can result in avascular necrosis. Stem cells can also promote wound healing, like in diabetic ulcers, chronic ulcers. Advantage of fat over bone marrow. I commonly inject fat stem cells. Earlier I was injecting bone marrow stem cells. Fat has got several advantages over bone marrow, and these are enumerated here. There is a relative paucity of cells in the bone marrow when compared to the fat. Fat contains 500 to 2000 times more MSCs than the same volume of bone marrow. The cells in fat have the highest proliferation potentials, and the cells are younger than bone marrow. In older people, it may be difficult to obtain cells from the bone marrow because there is osteoporosis. In addition to adult stem cells, fat also contains numerous other regenerative cells that are important to the healing process. The further advantages when performing a procedure by doctors. The procedure of doing it with fat is less painful, very important. I can aspirate it from the thigh, and the patient can go home the same day within a few hours. Whereas with the bone marrow, it takes some time. No anticoagulants are required. If you take bone marrow, you have to treat it immediately with anticoagulants like heparin. You have to inject anticoagulant into the bone to prevent it clotting as the bone marrow is being aspirated into the needle. This can result in overdose or leakage of the heparin anticoagulant solution into the adjacent tissue, or even when it sometimes the iliac crest, from the posterior part of the iliac crest, it can result in penetration and spread of the heparin from bone marrow aspirate in the retroperitoneal space, leading to a retroperitoneal hematoma. Stem cells derived from fat tissue also are a better source for articular cartilage repair, and therefore it is superior to differentiate into cartilage. What is the benefit of MSC treatment in osteoarthritis, commonly for the knee joint? Some patients have been able to get prolonged pain relief, and they have postponed a knee replacement. The longest follow-up stem cells are from up to 6 years and continuing. These patients have avoided a knee replacement. In the short term, they can avoid taking NSCs and painkillers, or they can avoid opioids. Thanks for watching. These are my social media links. If you haven't subscribed already, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, Madras Joint Replacement Center. Share with your friends and relatives if they need a stem cell procedure. Like it, give it a thumbs up. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.